Fences still up around the Edmonton area church that's been long defying Alberta public health orders. A judge ruling today that no charter rights were violated when Pastor James Coates was ticketed for not enforcing COVID-19 restrictions here at GraceLife Church. Quiet at the Stony Plain Courthouse, lawyers for both sides appearing virtually. The judge reminding both the issue at play is a ticket from December 20th, and there is no question the public health order was broken. Pastor Coates has admitted in court to not keeping to the 15% of fire code capacity mandated and refusing to police members at GraceLife for masking and physical distancing, but argues the law itself goes against his charter-protected rights. A judge ruling the ticket itself doesn't break those rights, and arguments that Alberta Health Services took part in relentless harassment or tried to censor Pastor Coates goes against the facts of the case, and that AHS took reasonable steps to not disturb the religious gathering. On the fundamental rights to religion and freedom of expression, saying there are limits, and because private businesses face similar restrictions, it's not religious persecution. While Coates' lawyers argued he had to turn 85% of his congregation away, the judge ruling because the health order was ignored, this didn't happen. On the question of the pastor's 35 days in jail in relation to a second ticket and bail conditions he refused to follow, while his lawyers argued this went against his right to freedom of conscience, the judge saying this is separate from this case because Coates pleaded guilty to the charge that ultimately put him in jail, and the bail conditions are needed for public safety. Coates' lawyers saying they are already considering an appeal on what they claim are serious errors in law. Now, the next legal question is the big one. Does Alberta's public health order as a whole go against the Canadian Charter of Rights and Freedoms? That question is being applied to Coates' ticket, as well as a number of other ones here in Alberta, but we'll hear about them at a later date. From Parkland County, Carly Robinson, City News.